What if a life form from a faraway place came to your neighborhood and started causing havoc? Sounds pretty scary, right? Well, that kind of thing is actually happening in Texas right now. Invasive species are attacking. In nature, plants and animals generally stick to their home area. Alligators, for example, live in freshwater environments like ponds and wetlands, so the areas that they naturally go or range is limited. The species that have been in the same place for a long time are called natives. Alligators are natives of freshwater environments. They don't really go places where there is no freshwater. Within an ecological community, different species have to compete for limited resources. Some may get eaten by their natural predators, or some may run out of resources that are also being used by other species. It all works in balance, so that generally, no one species can totally outcompete the others. But some species can live in other places too, but historically they haven't had a means to get from one place to another. When a plant or animal happens to get to a place where it has never been found before, we say it has been introduced to a new ecosystem. And the newcomers are called exotic, alien, or non-native species. Sometimes non-native species don't have much of an impact. In fact, only about 10% of exotic species survive in a new ecosystem. Of those that do survive, about 10% outcompete the natives, take their place, and become invasive. There's little to stop them from taking over. Their natural predators are far away, and they can use up all the resources that were once shared among native species. And invasive species can do real damage, not just to the ecosystem, but also to human infrastructure. For example, zebra mussels, originally native to the seas of Eastern Europe and the Middle East, have taken over some Texas waterways and have damaged water pipes, boats and their engines, buoys, and even air conditioners, in addition to destroying habitat. In the U.S., invasives cause more than $120 billion in damages and control costs each year. That's more than 6 times the annual budget of NASA. So what can you do to help? Well, first, remember that it is illegal to transport a known invasive. So when you travel, leave plants and animals where you found them. When on the water, be sure to clean, drain, and dry your boat. Plants and animals can hitch a ride between waters on unwashed boats. And some of the native plants here in Texas can be invasive elsewhere. Washing your boat keeps them from moving around. Also, get involved with a local work group that removes invasives from public lands. Your local chapter of Master Naturalists should know when the next workday is. With a little effort, we can keep the aliens from invading.